So we've decided to give it another go. See what happens. If anyone's got anything to say, they might as well say it now.
You know what I think? I'm not one of your kids, am I?
That's it then. Whatever Pap and I decide to do, you all have to accept it.
There's nothing you can do about it, you know. David and Mother, they do have a right to live their own lives.
His funeral.
Why get so hung up about it?
I'm not.
Oh, no, you've just been on a real downer all evening.
Sorry. Yeah, well, what Dave said did upset me, but I was in a bad mood to start with. Oh, it's work. I'm sick of flogging tarted up junk.
Hey.
Oh, I know I have to get used to it. How would you feel when this kid came in this afternoon, right, all excited about getting his first set of wheels, because he goes for the biggest load of junk in the yard? Not that it looked it. You know the story, high polished job, low price tag. Well, the boss hung around the whole time to make sure I said all the right things to get a sale. That sort of thing's going on all the time.
Well, get out of it then. Get a job with a firm who aren't out to rip people off.
Easier said than done.
Well, from what I've heard, you've never stayed around in a job you hated before.
I've had a wife to support before. I tried for a couple of others.
You tell me.
I didn't get them, so it's no use.
I wasn't going to mention it till it was a bit more definite. Well, I know you've been unhappy.
What have you done?
I asked John if he could get Southern Freight to take you on.
I've got a truck license.
But you could get one. I mean, you've told me you've driven light trucks in the Northwest.
Yeah, but nothing like those monsters that Southern Freight runs. Listen, I don't need you lining up jobs for me.
But you just told me how hard they are to get.
Well, you should have asked me about it first. I mean, the pay wouldn't be anywhere near the same.
But you'd be a lot happier.
Look, I want a roof over our heads before the kids start coming. I need every cent I can get.
I don't mind waiting for a house.
I do. When I married you, I promised your father I'd look after you. That means a home of our own as soon as I can get it.
God, you are so stubborn.
All right, I am stubborn. But I'll stick with what I've got until I can find something that pays as well or better. All right?
Interrupt a minute.
Got a lot to do.
We should clear the air, Kev.
You don't have to say anything, Dad. I'm not going to buy into it anymore. I've got enough on my plate.
I want you to understand.
I reckon I do. A bit.
I still love you, Mum. But I'm not the sort who can live by myself.
You don't reckon this bloke dying will make any difference?
Oh, I don't want your mother to come back because of that.
And the rebound, you mean?
That's what it'd be.
It mightn't have been that serious.
She was going to go overseas with him. Well, you might as well know the lot. Don't get too head up about what I said tonight. Early days. Pat and I won't be making any decisions until we're absolutely sure how things are going.
It's fair enough.
But we have to think of the future. You know, the way I used to feel about Pat was pretty much like you and Lynn, I reckon. Young, but the feeling's there. That sort of thing stays, even after all these years, and everything that's happened.
You still love her like that?
No, not the same, but there's still something there. She's been good, she's helped us. It just feels like we'd be happy together.
I won't make any waves, Dad.
Mean a lot. Gordon treated her pretty bad when they broke up. Oh, she hasn't said anything, but she's been hurt.
I'll try to be nice to her.
Thanks, son.
Rosie?
Must be still at the nursing home. Gives us more time together.
Gail, what happened was...
It was great.
I should never have let it happen.
I wanted to.
It makes me no better than Wayne.
Oh, that was different. Wayne was drunk. It was just different. It's funny, you know. I didn't want to come and live here. But if I hadn't, we'd have never met each other.
Listen, Gail, there are a few...
None of the guys I liked before ever really liked me. I mean, they just... Oh, you know. None of them ever asked me out to dinner. I could tell you liked me. Right from when I first arrived. I won't say anything.
Oh, got back, have you? Had dinner ready for you inside.
Sorry, Rosie.
Oh, we went for a ride on the bike and we were having such a good time that we didn't want to come home so soon. We had tea at a hamburger place.
You could have rung.
We got talking and forgot the time. Please don't be mad at us, Rosie.
Well, I suppose young people have to get out and enjoy themselves.
Yeah.
No, I don't have to worry about you with Paul.
I've got some papers I should read.
Night.
Oh, he's still upset about Mr. Mason, I reckon.
Oh, I think I was able to cheer him up a bit.
Hi. Nice night? Oh, we added some greasy hamburger joint. It's still sitting there.
Board meeting tomorrow, I suppose.
Yep.
Try not to let it get to you.
Need to keep a clear head. Oh, I won't be saying much. Only telling them I'm getting out.
Of Rambo?
Yeah. It's not my scene.
Do you think you should throw it in? Just like that.
Can't handle it.
I know what happened to Howler's been preying on your mind. But don't make any hasty decisions. Better to wait for a while. Till you're thinking clearly.
It's not just that. Today, I... Today, I decided to pack my bags and disappear.
To go where? To do what?
I don't know. I just know that I've got to get out.
Sit down and have breakfast with me, Rosie.
I've already had mine. I'll have a cuppa.
I'm a bit worried about Paul.
He's still a bit upset about Mr. Mason, isn't he?
He's talking about taking off. I tried to talk sense to him, but he's too upset to listen.
Pity to see him go.
I enjoy having him here.
Wayne's pretty upset too, you know. Haven't seen you going out of your way to talk to him.
I don't think he feels anything very deeply.
A lot more than you reckon.
I see he's managed to get back into your good books again.
It'll be a long time before I can forget what he tried to do to Gail. I can't just cut him off. He needs someone. He needs you.
He couldn't give a damn about me.
He wants you to care about him. You're his father.
I don't know that I care about being reminded of the fact.
Oh, I never thought I'd hear you say something like that. He's your son, yours and Nancy's.
It's funny the way he's turned out so much like Patricia.
Whose fault's that?
I probably did neglect him as a child.
Not only then. You treat young Paul more like your son than you do Wayne.
I'm sorry, Rosie, you're probably right. But it's too late for Wayne and I ever to get close.
Well, I suppose I'd better go and do some more bacon and eggs for the others.
Already on.
Oh, nice not to have to do everything.
You seem to be in a good mood this morning.
Why shouldn't I be? I like it here.
Good, we hoped you would.
Morning.
Morning, Paul.
I'll get you bacon and eggs.
Well, something certainly changed her attitude.
Yeah.
I know you originally came here because of Patricia. You don't really have to go because she has.
I didn't think about it that way. I've come to feel at home here. But I am leaving, Mr. Hamilton.
When?
I can't till a new managing director's been appointed and things are back on an even keel.
That's a bit better. Give yourself time to think.
I wish I didn't, but I do have responsibilities. Not that I'm sure I'm cut out for them.
If I can help at all.
Might take you up on that. I'm supposed to rely on Patricia and Fiona for their advice, but they can't agree on anything. And I was supposed to rely on Hal's business experience now. I'm a bit at sea.
Well, the first thing you have to do is find yourself a new managing director, someone you're sure you can trust. Anyone in mind?
Well, a couple of people in the company have been nominated, but I won't support them. I don't think they've got what it takes. We'll have to look outside the company for someone of Hal's calibre.
What about the manager of your Melbourne branch?
Well, he'll be all right as a fill-in, but I don't think so long term.
Well, just remember, if I can advise you in any way at all.
Thanks. I really appreciate you letting me stay. And all you've done for me.
Left you around a bit late this morning, mate. You missed breakfast.
Not bludging this time.
Hi.
Angie and I have got a surprise for you.
If it's about truck driving.
Thanks, but no thanks.
I told him he's dead against it.
Why not? You'd have no trouble getting your truck license.
Not Patricia, is it? Being involved in the company.
I'm not that touchy. If it paid more than my present job, I'd be all for it. Right now, my main concern's earning a quid, and I better get to it. See ya.
Bye.
Thanks for the trouble. See you later.
Sorry. Should have asked him first. I don't know what's got into him lately. He's usually so easygoing.
Oh, he wants what's best for you. You can't blame him for that.
We're all right here for the moment. We could get a small flat, but he's just got his heart set on getting a house. It'd be different if I was pregnant. But I'm not.
Oh, plenty of time.
Yeah.
I'm glad we're seeing a bit more of you lately.
I try and leave Rob and Angela to themselves when I can. They haven't had much time since they're married.
You're a good kid, right?
Has anyone seen my maths, Brooke?
You took him to bed with you last night.
Well, he's really worried about his exams.
Ah, he's right. He's always had it up here.
Didn't you want to do some shopping? I'll fix this. I'm on afternoon shift.
Oh, that'd be great. I'll get Davey ready.
Thank you.
You didn't say much after you heard what I told the others last night.
Didn't want to say too much in front of Kev. Guess he's not happy about it.
Well, he's trying to be fair. He finds it hard.
It's hard on all of us. Main thing I want is for you to be happy.
Ah, thanks, love.
Only, well, I can't help wondering if you've thought of the practicalities.
Just you.
Someone has to.
Oh, what sort of things?
Well, if you and Patricia do get together, how are you going to work it? I mean, you're both used to such different lifestyles.
Just sort it out as we go along.
You ought to think about it. It's going to be different to what it was like with Mum. Can't see Patricia giving up everything she's used to be just a housewife.
Just a housewife?
I'm serious, Dad. It's going to be hard. She live here, I want you to move in with her.
I just thought we'd live here, I suppose.
Asking a lot of her. Giving up that big house, a whole life. Seems to me you're both going to have to make a lot of compromises.
I suppose we will. Oh, hi.
Hi. Did you see Fiona? I must have just missed her. The chef at the restaurant gave me a great recipe for paprika chicken. Fiona's just dropped down the shop to get what we need.
Oh.
Something wrong?
I just wanted to talk to Fiona.
Oh, she won't be long. I can disappear.
You might be better, actually. You've had more to do with Gail. I've done something pretty terrible. I was feeling lousy about Hal's death. And we went for a ride on my bike. I don't know, I felt so miserable. And she...
You mean you and she...
I don't know how it happened. And now she thinks it's a big romance.
And you don't give a damn about her?
You know me better than that. I care about her, but not that way.
Well, you should have thought about that in the first place. I mean, I gave you credit for more intelligence. You must have known how she felt about you. What are you going to do about it?
I'm thinking of leaving.
Oh, terrific. I mean, Gail might act tough,
But she's been kicked around all her life. How's she going to feel if you just up and leave?
She's misunderstood the whole thing.
Yeah. She thought you were a nice guy who cared about her. And all she got was another version of Wade.
I'm not like that.
Oh, no. You get the same thing by being nice.
I suppose it looks that way.
Too right it does. It's going to be a kick in the guts for Rosie as well.
I just wanted to do the right thing by everybody.
Well, don't stand here talking to me about it. Go and sort it out with Gail. But do it properly. Hi, how's your day?
Same as usual.
This always gives me a lift, a letter from Bill. It's great when I write to him now, knowing he'll write back.
Yeah, it is great.
Oh, I wish I could see him more than once a week. At least it's something.
Really admire you, Susie. The way you're hanging in there, waiting for him.
And I'm going to keep on doing it.
Where's Angie?
Oh, she had to go out for a while.
What for?
One for you, too. Readdressed from Mount Macedon. From a girl. One of the old flames, I bet.
Kerry Mitchell.
Remember her?
Yeah. Well, it'd be 3 years ago now.
She was an old flame.
Not quite so much of the old. She was quite a looker. Lives in Sydney now.
Bet she doesn't know you're married. You're going to have to write and tell her.
Another broken heart.
I'm going to make a cuppa.
I'll be in there.
Hope all your old girlfriends
don't start writing or
the person will have a heart attack.
Been quite a few, haven't they? Rob?
Hmm?
Your girlfriend. Been a bit of a Casanova, haven't you?
Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Thanks. What did she want? Just ran into an old friend we both knew. Thought she'd drop a line.
Nice of her.
Open. You've come to tell me that you're shooting through. You may as well save your breath.
Oh, listen.
I overheard Mr. Hamilton.
Listen, Gail, I am not going to be doing that.
You can go to hell for all I care. You're as bad as everyone else. She'll get sick of me next, won't take long.
It's not you I want to get away from. It's my business worries.
Yeah, sure.
Will you listen to me? I want to get away from Ramberg. I want to get away from all the responsibilities. But I am not going to walk out on you.
No?
No. What do you want out of it? You and me?
I don't know. I want you to go around with me. I think I'm crazy, but the other night at the restaurant, I felt so good because I was with you. It was like you were my boyfriend.
You can do better than me.
Got to be kidding.
Okay. The first thing we'll have to do is tell Rosie. I don't want her sneaking around behind anyone's back.
Oh, Paul, I love you so much.
You sure you want to go back to driving?
Oh, yeah, I'd be a lot happier. I'm not cut out for paperwork. I want to keep moving.
Well, with the company behind you, she'll have a good chance of getting it.
Yeah, Pat's not too keen.
Well, she'll just have to wear it, won't she? I mean, if it's what you want to do, she shouldn't mind.
Yeah, Susie said something this morning, and I reckon she's right. Pat and I'll have to iron a few things out. Have a bit of give and take.
That's the only way to make a go of things. But you should stick to your guns on this one. Not you that has to face up to the job every day.
No, Pat'll understand.
She should if she really wants it to work between you. Things like you've got to get sorted out at the start.
Fair enough.
Any couple has to know where they stand with each other.
Money bags?
Wish I was.
No commission check.
You know how slow they are with it? Where have you been?
The doctor.
Anything the matter?
Oh, no. Just a test.
What for?
To see if I'm okay to have kids.
Why shouldn't you be?
Oh, I probably am. It's just that nothing's happened yet.
Give it time.
We have been trying for quite a while. The doctor wants you to make an appointment too. Well, if there is something wrong, it mightn't be me.
Oh, it damn well isn't me.
Come on, don't do the male pride bit. It's a simple test. They want to check out every possibility. I mean, you do want to have kids, don't you? I made an appointment for tomorrow lunchtime.
We can cancel it.
Come on.
Look, I don't need the tests. I know I'm okay.
How can you?
I just know, that's all. I'm going down the shop.
It changes your